Well, good afternoon and welcome to David's Bowl Party. So it is a privilege to get to be here together. Excited to have everyone that is with us today. So we will do some quick introductions. So we're the Simpson family. Trent and I have seven children and this is our seventh Bowl. Our parents are here. So my parents are here from East Tennessee, if you want to wave. My in-laws are here from Northwest Iowa, sister from Minnesota. Hamani and Halabaji are here from Chicago along with uncle. Sensing him and Nam, which are our Korean teacher and husband, and then friends. So let me start by introducing the full custom and the tradition, because the question always arises, how in the world did we start this? So, the toll custom is very ancient. As Americans, we have no appreciation for ancient history. Our history is not that long. But in Korea, which has a very, very long and very distinct history, they have managed to remain separate from other Asian nations around them. So they have their own distinct language, culture, traditions. Even the clothing has remained entirely distinct. So China has its own custom and language. Korea is very separate. Japan is very separate. And as Americans, we just kind of wash over Asia as like it's one, but it's very separate. So this Korean tradition arose because of a high infant mortality rate. Korea is very mountainous, and it's about at the same latitude as we are in Iowa, so very hot summers, very cold, harsh winters, and so until recent times, the infant mortality rate was high. But if a child made it to their first birthday, their chance of living to adulthood increased greatly, and so celebrating the first birthday became a large tradition. So on the morning of the first birthday, in antiquity, the mother and the grandmother would rise early to start preparing the full table that you see before us. They would prepare the fruits and the rice cake, and they would also offer prayers of blessing for this child making it to the first birthday. Then they would get the child dressed in his special full book, the special costume that David is wearing today. The family would gather to join in the celebration, and when everyone was gathered, they would celebrate the toll custom. So the child would be brought to this beautifully arranged table. And on the table, there would be, of course, the rice cake and the fruit, but there's also four special items. There's money, rice, special calligraphy brush, and a very long piece of thread. So once the child is brought to the table, he is allowed to choose one of these four items. So the money represents wealth, the rice represents health, the calligraphy brush represents wisdom or scholarship, and the long thread represents long life. Once the child has made his decision about what he wants to choose, the family then celebrates by sharing the rice cake and the fruit, and they also present the child with specific gifts. So the custom is to give the child gold rings, and they used to save those gold rings, and then when the child would get married, they'd melt them down, and that's the gold they would use to make their spouse's wedding ring. So today, you'll notice David is wearing his very special gold ring. So when he comes up, you'll be able to see that on his hand. So in our ceremony, instead of just the grandparent and the mother blessing the child in private before the party, that has become the central part of our party, is the celebration of the blessings. So our first blessing will be done by Halabaji. So if we can bring David up. Thank you.
Okay, let us pray. 말씀으로 세상을 창조하시고 우주를 주관하시는 하나님 아버지, 감사와 찬양을 드리며 주님의 이름을 높입니다. 특별히 주님의 귀한 뜻 가운데 이제 1년 전에 우리 데이빗을 심슨 패밀리의 일곱 번째 자녀로 보내주시고 그동안의 여러 가지 여건 가운데서도 저를 복되게 하여 주셨음을 감사합니다. 이 시간에 아버지여, 장차의 데이빗에 대해서 행해질 모든 미래에 관해서 아버지여 축복하기를 원합니다. 무엇보다도 믿음의 큰 장로가 되기를 원합니다. 특별히 이제 아버지 학교에 다니게 될 때 지혜와 총명을 허락하여 주셔서 하나님의 귀한 일꾼으로 이 땅에 아버지여 복되고 복된 인생을 살아가기를 간절히 소망합니다. 늘 하늘의 신령한 목과 이 땅의 귀한 것으로 믿음의 큰 대장부가 되게 주여 도와주시고 이 세상에서 참으로 빛을 발하는 귀한 빛의 자녀로 많은 사람들에게 크리스찬의 영역을 미치는 아들로 세워주시기를 간절히 소원합니다. 하나님 앞에 늘 영광을 돌리며 많은 사람들에게 아버지여 예수 그리스도의 사랑을 전하는 은혜의 통로로 저를 사용하여 주시옵소서. 만나는 사람마다 주님의 축복을 나누길 수 있도록 주여 도와주시고 평생에 살아있는 동안에 하나님의 영광을 위하여 주님께 귀하게 쓰임받는 큰 제목이 될 수 있도록 도와주시기를 간절히 소망합니다. 특별히 믿음 가운데 복음의 역사가 나타나게 주여 도와주시고 그의 지경이 넓어지게 주여 도와주셔서 늘 아버지여 영육간의 강건함으로 하나님의 축복을 매일매일 삶 가운데 누리는 귀하고 복된 인생이 되기를 간절히 소원하며 예수 그리스도의 이름으로 감사하며 기도드리옵나이다. 아멘.
아멘.
Grandma and I pray for our grandkids and our children for that every day. And so this is more or less what we pray for. Mainly our concern is salvation for our grandchildren. We want them to spend eternity with all of us. And so this is our prayer. Okay, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to ask for your divine care of David. We ask that you would bless David, that he comes to know you at an early age and receive Christ as his Savior. We want to arouse in him the desire to yield to your word and to the authority it has in his life, knowing your word and being obedient to it. Lord, give David wisdom and success in his endeavors in life. I ask that you would continue to bless David and his entertaining and sweet personality, and bestow on him the blessing of a long, healthy life with a family of his own. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
First of all, I'd like to thank all of you for coming out. Be a little preemptive, because I think Jennifer and Trey are going to do it. Thank you for the Chum family and their support. And I would like to say on behalf of my wife, Cheryl, and I, how much we really appreciate the Chum family. They've been so gracious to us. They've not missed any of these tolls. And they've provided some of the things that you see here. So from Cheryl and I to Jay and Kay, we thank you very much. I'd like to pray for David, and I'm going to have Trent hold him. He's a pretty good handful. And so I'm going to ask just Trent to hold on to him while we say a brief prayer. Lord, we just thank you so much for this assembly, for those that have come out to rejoice with us. I'm thankful for those friends that you have brought in their lives, that support them, love on them. We just thank you for all of those individuals, for those that have volunteered their time today to come and be a part of this special occasion. I'd like to thank you for David and this addition to our family. And we ask, Father, now that you would, David, that you would bless and keep David, make your face to shine upon him, and be gracious to him. We ask you to lift up your countenance and give David peace as he goes through his life. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
All right, we now... as you know, not everyone was able to be here today, so we have recorded some special blessings from great-grandpa Frank, and from my two brothers, my brother who's in Kentucky, and my brother who's in Hong Kong. So we will enjoy those now.
David. Gabriel Simpson. Grandpa, I've been talking to you every morning ever since you've been here. I got your picture over there. I say good morning to you every morning, tell you I love you, and I do love you. You're my 17th great-grandchild, and I love you to pieces. And Jesus loves you too, you know that, don't you, huh? Your mom and daddy loves you, and your brothers and sisters loves you. You got so much love, you don't know what to do with it. Gabe, I want to read the 139th Psalm here a little bit. I will praise thee, for I'm fearfully and wonderfully made, that my soul knoweth right well. Thy stuff was not hid from thee when I was made in the secrets and curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. Thine eyes did see my substance, yet being unperfect. And in thy book all my members were written, which in continuous were fastened when yet as there was none of them. How precious also are thy thoughts unto me, O God. How great is the sum of them. If I should count them, they are more in the numbers than the sand. When I awake, I am still with thee. Surely thou wilt slay the wicked, O God. Depart from me, therefore, you bloody men. And I love you, you precious. You're my 17th great-grandbaby. I love them all. Love you too. Jesus loves you. I want you to know that. I want you to grow up knowing that. I love you.
Hello, David. And on behalf of Aunt Carol and Josiah, Ava, Maddie, and myself, we just want to wish you a very joyful and blessed first birthday. It's hard to believe it's already been a year. I just wanted to offer a blessing for you. David is one of my favorite people from the Bible. He is described as a man after God's own heart. He clearly loved the Lord, and it's always amazed me how he discovered his love for the Lord with so little scripture to go on. Most of the scripture he had was the laws of God. And from that, he was able to to really understand God's character and develop a deep and lifelong love for the Lord. So my prayer for you, I'm going to actually use David's own words, and this is my desire for you as well, that you would grow in your love for the Word of God, that if you follow his words, you will find the same joy, peace, wisdom, and strength as David did. And so David says these words in Psalm 119, starting at verse 97. He says, "Oh, how I love your law. I meditate on it all day long. Your commands make me wiser than my enemies, for they are ever with me. I have more insight than all my teachers, for I meditate on your statutes. I have more understanding than the elders, for I obey your precepts. I have kept my feet from every evil path, so that I might obey your word. I have not departed from your laws, for you yourself have taught me. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. I gain understanding from your precepts, and therefore I hate every wrong path." David, the word of God will guide you on the path of righteousness. And my prayer for you is that as you grow and develop into a man of God, that you would lean on his word, trust in his word, that you would learn to obey his word, and that as you do, you would find it to be sweeter than honey on your tongue, that you would love it the way David loved it, that you would be a man after God's own heart. So God bless you, and we look forward to meeting you very soon.
Hey David, this is my blessing for you, young man. You have a spirit of gentleness and peace. You welcome everybody as a friend, and you have a smile on your face, and I just see joy in you, and it's a tremendous blessing to you and to us. That's right. But here's what I want you to know as you get older, young man. Training for godliness has value in everything. And that's going to be your focus. And your parents are going to train you. They're going to raise you up to follow the Lord. That's right. And your aunt and your uncle, that's me, buddy, we're here to do the same. If you ever need counsel, we'll tell you, go after the Lord with all your heart, and he will lift you up. Okay? So just remember that gentle spirit that the Lord has given you, and look to him in all things, and he will light the path for you. Love you.
David picked. So as a reminder, there's the four items. So there's money, which is for riches or wealth, rice for health, the calligraphy brush for scholarship and wisdom, and the threads for a long life. So let's see if you choose. Let's see. Yeah. So in Korea, when we sing happy birthday, we stand. And we put our hands out like we're offering a gift. Because we are offering a gift. We'll give things to this boy. Between them, and not long after that, the younger son got together all he had and set off for a distant country. And there he squandered all his wealth in wild living. After he'd spent everything, there was a severe famine in that whole country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to a citizen of that country who sent him to the field to feed pigs. And he longed to fill his stomach with the pods the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. When he came to his senses, he said, "How many of my father's hired men have food to spare, and here I am starving to death? I will set out and go back to my father, and I will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son, but make me like one of your hired men.' So he got up and went to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and, filled with compassion for him, ran to kiss his son, threw his arms around him and kissed him. And the son too said to his father, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to the servants, 'Quick, get the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the fatted calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead, but he's alive again. He was lost and he's found.' And so they began to celebrate." So I will stop there, but the parallel that I didn't understand the first few times we did this, but that came to me later, was this is such an amazing gospel picture planted right in the middle of an ancient Korean custom. Because God's faithful. He was showing his heart, even in that tradition, long before anybody saw it. So David, like all of us, has been born a sinner. And boy, does it show. We say not to do something, and he smiles at us and moves right towards it. He's like the younger son in this picture. But we still have a gracious Heavenly Father. And when David comes to his senses and realizes his sin and repents and turns from it, God will receive him just the way the Father received his son. He will put on the gold ring, just like we celebrated. He'll put on the best clothes, just like we did today. They will have a celebration, and God will rejoice over David because he's come to his senses and come home and accepted the gospel. And so this becomes such a precious picture in our family of what we're praying for over David, that he will come to his senses and turn to Jesus and be forgiven of his sin and welcomed into the family of God. We're so thankful for Trent and I that we've experienced that, and for our children so far that have accepted it. But this has just been such a wonderful time, again, year after year, to remember the gospel, to remember the goodness God's displayed in our family, the bigger picture that God has always had that we just weren't seeing of what he was doing as he grafted us into this Korean family and Korean culture. So thank you so much for coming today and celebrating with us. So as all Korean families, after the ceremony, it is time to enjoy the duck and the fruit. So we will, and we will end while we're getting all these things downstairs and ready to go. We will end with a slideshow of David's first year. So we'll get this moved aside. And when the slideshow is over, you're welcome. So there's two things. We set up a table in the back with some of our treasures from Korea, so you can enjoy those. And feel free to ask the kids questions about the treasures, because a lot of them are things that they've brought back from Korea when we went, or things that are theirs. And then you can trickle downstairs and we'll have a reception time where you can enjoy the refreshments with us.
I slip in your room and I kneel down at your side with my hand on your chest as you take each breath. Here's what I pray for. One that he
for coming, and thank you especially to the Chung family, Sensei Nim and Nam. There is so much of this that is not possible without their families. Even getting the costumes and getting the rings and getting the screen and the foods, it would have been impossible for us on our own. So thank you again for all of your help and for sharing your culture with us. We are so grateful.